not out to your mother about your homosexuality and your female impersonation. How has this goal affected your performance as a female impersonator? In your bio, you say your greatest goal was achieved when you came out to your mother about your homosexuality and your female impersonation. How has this goal affected your performance as a female impersonator?
It's affected my performance as a female impersonator for the fact that I come from a large family. When I came out to my mother, I came out to my entire family, and they all stand behind each and everything I do. My mother is a promoter for another pageantry system, which is fabulous and you do not find very often. And I believe, considering a lot of homosexuals, you know, you come out to your family and you're usually disowned. I'm very fortunate, and I wish that on each and every one of you. Thank you very much.
In your bio, you said your hobbies include collecting movie star memorabilia and costume design. What do you feel is your most precious collected item and why? In your bio, you said your hobbies include collecting movie star memorabilia and costume design. You might fuck it up. What do you feel is your most precious collected item and why? Good luck.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen and judges, once again, I am contestant number 11, Maya Monroe. To answer the question just given before me, my reply is, I have this unusual, very, very unusual cigarette lighter. And it's just got this beautiful pitch. I mean, I can go on and on about this lighter, I'm sorry. But anyway, it once belonged to Betty Davis. The punchline. I've collected several things from different stars, photographs that have been signed, and also as far as costume designs, when designing, I oftentimes look at the outfits from the 40s, the 50s, what the stars were wearing then, and I get a lot of my creativity from them. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, for your consideration and judgment.
Come on!